Camera.
Are we online? Yes. Hi, if you're able to listen to this, my name is Amit Deb. I represent IIAD from Delhi. I work in the admissions team. I have Prachi ma'am with us. Prachi Mittal, she heads the foundation course in the college. Okay.
Good evening, everybody. I think today what we'll do is that we'll just take you through briefly the process of the entrance test at IIAD. If you pay attention and take notes, you will be able to understand what are our expectations from a candidate who's applying for admission at IIAD. So I hope that this presentation is helpful. The way we are conducting the webinar today evening is that I'll begin with a few slides and you're free to take notes from this. And we'll brief you about the exam format and our expectations, after which we will be ready to take your questions. I hope you have all also received the sample paper and have gone through them. So keep your queries ready as soon as we are done with the presentation, which would take about 10-15 minutes. We'll be ready to take your questions. So as you all know, the entrance test at IIAD is for these programs which you see on your screen: the BA Honours in Fashion Design, Communication Design, Interior Architecture and Design, as well as MA in Fashion Design. The entrance exam for these four courses is called as iDAT, which is the IIAD Design Aptitude Test. Then for our other two programs, which are not the design programs, for BA Honours Fashion Business Management, MA Fashion Business Management, we have what we call as iMAT, which is the IIAD's Management Aptitude Test. I will begin with the details of iDAT. So all applicants, both bachelors as well as masters, for all design programs can pay attention right now. And applicants for Management Aptitude Test can wait for a while. Towards the end of my presentation, we'll address that as well. So as you all know, the winter round of our entrance exam is scheduled for 20th and 21st December. I hope you've marked it on your calendar. Sorry, 21st and 22nd December. Basically, what we are looking for are individuals who are passionate about design learning. When I say passionate about design learning, what we want is people who are inquisitive, observant, sensitive to their surroundings, and open to new ideas, people who are explorers, people who are excited about making. Why I'm taking a little while to explain these ideas to you is because when you write your paper, when you appear for the entrance exam, these are the qualities that you need to bring out through your responses in the paper. So we will definitely be able to check your observation. We will be able to check whether you're sensitive to your surroundings. By that I mean, are you sensitive visually? Are you observing things visually? Are you aware of your surroundings, the general awareness that we have about things around us? If you claim yourself to be passionate about design learning, we hope that you will be able to exhibit to us some basic knowledge and understanding, okay? And excited about making. I'll share with you how we are testing that as well. So the iDAT is in two parts. The first part is the written test. The second part is what we call a studio simulator, which is for the bachelor's program, and an interview for the master's program. I'll start by briefing you about the written test. So the written test is for 2.5 hours and it'll be for 100 marks. It basically has three sections. The first section tests your creative and visual ability. Now in this, what we are checking, generally people think that in the entrance exam of a design college, you are being tested only for your sketching abilities. IIAD is different. We don't only expect you to have sketching abilities because we believe that is a skill that we can teach you. But what we need to check is that you have the basics that are required, basics such as observation. So have you been observing the environment around you? There will be a question that will test how well you have observed objects around you, and how well are you able to capture their details. Whenever you have a question like that, whenever you're responding to a question like that, please remember, don't think of making a photo finish sketch. Your sketch might not be resembling a photograph, as beautiful as a photograph, but it should capture the details. So if you are drawing a people leaf, we want to see, do you remember the proportions, the shape of a people leaf? How close to the color of the natural people leaf are you able to draw in your paper? Do you recall the veins that are there in the people leaf, and therefore are you able to draw that? So these are the kind of details that we will look for when we are selecting candidates for admission into IIAD. The next is, we are testing your imaginative thinking. Now, a lot of students think that imaginative thinking is about doing something different. Imagination is actually about coming up with clever ideas. So whatever question is being put to you, think of a clever solution to that. And do not try to be different for the sake of being different. The third thing that we test is your composition skills. Composition skills is basically how you are arranging different elements on a in a space, on a piece of paper. So make your space well utilized. I'm repeating myself that we are not only testing for excellent sketching abilities. We believe sketching is just a tool through which you communicate. And if and when you join IIAD, we will be able to train you for it. So for all your sketches, be mindful of the proportions you're drawing. Be mindful of the details you're drawing. If you know that there is a screw in some object, make sure you draw the screw. If you know that there is a nail for a joint in a furniture, draw the nail. If you know that, if you want to show a wooden furniture, please capture the texture of wood. We will be happy to see such responses. Okay, so please remember that we are not looking for photo finish drawings or for something different for the sake of being different. All questions in the creative and visual ability section will be tested through drawing tasks. Okay, moving to the next section, which is the cultural awareness. Now, we built in this section because we believe that design is an activity which requires its practitioners to be aware of their culture. There will be simple questions. These are not going to be very high order testing, but if you are claiming to be passionate about design, we hope that you know the basic facts that are around us in the world of art and in the world of culture, both within India as well as world. You don't really need to go and look, pick up guidebooks and start mugging up answers for it. But if you have been passionate about design, if you've been sensitive to your surroundings, if you know the basic regional culture of our country, if you know, if you recognize visually objects that belong to different cultures, different countries, then you will be doing well in this section. Questions in this section will include short writing tasks and one word answers. So there'll be a question, list of questions, about 15 of them, which you need to answer with a single word. And these are testing your awareness of facts, the cultural facts. Short writing tasks, we will also be looking at your use of the English language. So be careful about what you write over there. In any question where we are asking you to write and draw, make sure you attempt both. And there will be instructions which will tell you that when are you supposed to write. Don't miss the writing part, because we want to understand from you what are you depicting in your sketch. The final section of the paper will test your logical thinking. We want to test whether you understand relationships between objects. So there can be questions like complete the series. There can be questions like what comes next. We are also testing your visual thinking. Are you able, there'll be a question with an image given and you might be asked to visualize its other side and then choose from the options that is given. All questions in logical thinking will be multiple choice questions. So just repeating, three sections to the written test. The first is creative visual ability, which is almost 50% of the paper, then cultural awareness and logical thinking. The cultural awareness and logical thinking are mostly objective type questions, either one word or multiple choice questions. In your writing tasks, remember to be careful about the English that you're using. Then the second part of the exam is a studio simulator. So in the morning, you write your the written test, and then in the afternoon, you will be going for the second part of the exam, which is a studio simulator. Now, we at IIAD consider this to be an exciting part of the examination process, because what it does is it simulates, it recreates the environment of a studio at IIAD. When you join IIAD, this is how you will be learning. This is the kind of learning environment you will be in. And we put you in that environment with the tutors, give you a task that you work on. And the tutors are there not as only examiners. They are there to guide you. They will mentor you through the task. They will be interacting with you. They will be helping you to achieve the task. What we want to test over here is that how do you take to the learning environment of IIAD? That you may know a few things, you may not know a few things. But if there is a tutor who's helping you with ideas, are you able to take those ideas and does that help you perform? We are basically checking whether you fit into the learning style at IIAD or not. So it'll be a group task, because at IIAD, we work in project-based learning, which requires a lot of group tasks. So you, for this particular studio simulator, you will be working in a small group, which will be created right then and there. And you will be given some materials. You will be given a task that you as a group have to achieve. Now, the thing to remember here is that what you create, the outcome, is not as important as the way you create it. The 2 hours you spend in discussing with your peers about the ideas, in communicating with the tutors and handling the materials, we will be observing that. Only getting a beautiful outcome at the end of it is not the way to get into IIAD. The things we are specifically looking for is creative thinking, which is the same as having clever ideas, because there'll be a problem given to you, there'll be some materials given to you, and you'll have to create a 3D model to solve that problem using the material that has been given to you. Now, can you think of clever ideas, or are you going to create something which is an obvious response? So if I ask you to create something to carry 4 cups of tea, are you going to just create a tray? That's an obvious response. Or can you think of a different, a clever idea to carry 4 cups of tea? That's what we will be looking at. The second is problem solving, because you are given limited material. You are also working with people whom you do not know earlier. So there is a lot of problem solving that is involved, which leads me to teamwork. So we are seeing how well you work with people. Are you able to put your point across to your teammates? Are you able to collaborate with them? Are you able to support them? And together as a team, are you able to deal with the situation that has been given to you? The final is communication. Throughout the studio simulator, you are constantly interacting either with your peers or with the tutors, IIAD tutors, who will be there to mentor you. We are testing how well you communicate. This is not about fluent English. It is about being able to communicate your idea. And communication is not only talking, communication is also listening. So do you have good listening skills? Are you able to communicate and get your idea across to your peers as well as to the tutor? There will also be opportunities where you will be asked to specifically present your idea. That is again a place where we are testing your communication skills. So feel free, don't feel that it's an exam. Act your natural self, have fun. That is the way to crack the studio simulator at least. All the materials that you will use for studio simulator will be provided by IIAD. We don't expect you to carry any material from home for this. Okay, now that is for the bachelor's program. This, while the IDAT, the written exam, is the same for MA and BA as an exam, the questions will be different, but the first part is a written exam for both MA and BA. The second part for MA students, MA applicants, is an interview. During the interview, we are basically checking for your interest in fashion and therefore your awareness about fashion, and we are checking your communication and presentation. How do you present yourself? How do you communicate? You can bring a portfolio if you want. If you have a portfolio with work, which is creative work, which is your sketches, in case you have done studied design or fashion or art, either at your plus two level, which is in school, or at your bachelor's level, then you are free to bring that portfolio. However, from our end, it's not compulsory. Okay. Now, what should you be bringing to IIAD that for your exam? Your basic stationery, including pencil, eraser, pen, any color medium. So please do bring your color medium, because there will be a few questions that will specifically require you to use color. And if you don't use color, then you lose out on those questions. We don't mark you on it. So get whatever color medium that you are comfortable with. We will not specify which medium you can use. You can use pencil colors, you can use dry pastels, oil pastels, crayons, any of that, but no watercolors, no water-based, no acrylic colors which are wet, because that's not something that's possible in that time. Get your scale, cutter, scissor, tape, glue, fevicol, the general stuff. But if you get your the first four on the screen that are being shown here, the pencil, eraser, pen, color medium, and scale, you're good to go. Cutter, scissor, tape, glue, fevicol, we will provide you for the studio simulator. But if you are more comfortable getting your own, you can get it. Okay, now moving on to the management aptitude test, which happens again on the same days. And this is for specifically for people who are applying for fashion business management, both at the bachelor's level as well as the master's level. Again, there are two parts to the exam. The first part in the morning is a written test, and then followed by an interview. Now, the written test here is a two-hour test, and it has questions which test your logical reasoning, awareness of fashion, basic awareness of fashion, and your English language. These are the three areas that we are testing. So logical reasoning and awareness of fashion, you will have multiple choice questions, and there is no negative marking in the multiple choice questions. The English language, we are testing your understanding of grammar and comprehension. So there will be short writing tasks as well as some multiple choice questions. And then this happens in the morning. In the afternoon, you will be interviewed. We are basically looking for your interest in business and management, your awareness of fashion, and again, your communication and presentation skills. So make sure that you're presenting yourself also formally for the interview. I think that's just about it, what I want to say and brief you regarding the two types of tests that we have. Some general instructions. You know, our paper has clear instructions. A lot of times candidates in hurry do not read the instructions completely. If you read the instructions carefully, the task will be clear for you, with you. If you're not clear about the instructions, don't hesitate to ask. There will be people around who can help you and clarify. With every question, we also give what we are assessing on. Read that. It will help you write your answer or draw your answer, because you'll be able to see what are we assessing. If it says that we're assessing on your visual memory, then it means that we want you to, but we are testing your observation. If it says accuracy and representation of detail, then don't miss out on details. If it says that we are testing your composition skills or your creative thinking, please take care that you include that in your responses. And manage your time well. A lot of times we have seen that students have spent too much time on one or two questions, and as a result have not been able to attempt the rest of them. Don't do that. Attempt all questions. go over the paper, allocate your time, and attempt all questions. You may pay more attention to a couple of questions which you are more confident of, but make sure that you attempt all questions, because that's an easy way to lose your admission seat with us by not attempting questions. And at the end of it, be neat. Don't give us a shabby paper. Be neat in it. Okay? And that's it. And now we are ready for to take your questions. So if there are any, Amit, would you like to give them instructions about how they can send us questions? They can type?
I think, yeah. So you can type out in the chat box about whatever questions you may have. And we'd read them out to you and then, answer. Yeah. That's us, guys. So that's me, Amit. Of course, Prachi, ma'am. So we're ready for your questions. I don't see yet. Be comfortable. Yeah, thanks. Okay, so let me brief you about the admission process, really. What all questions you can ask from me. So most of you would have received an email sent from us about your admit card, which will be sent by 14th of December. That's a Saturday. If you do not receive it by then, that email consists of my phone number and my email address. Please reach out. My name is Amit Deb. I'll look into it so that you get your admit card in time. I think that's about it. I've gotten some calls from a few students asking if the exams are on both the days. It's actually on one of these dates, 21st and 22nd of December. And most of you have chosen that date, and you will receive your admit card based on that date. Just bear with me, guys, for a second. I'm just trying to see if you've given us any questions. Okay, so I see a question around what is the difference between IDAT and IMAT. So IDAT is our students applying for design course. That, you know, it consists of two parts, part A and part B, as suggested by ma'am. It's the part A is a written test, part B is a studio simulation. IMAT is for fashion business management students who are applying for it, and which will again have two parts. Part A is the written test and part B is the personal interview. For postgraduate students, the written test remains the same. The structure and what we expect from it remains the same. Part B will be a personal interview where you can give us, you know, carry your portfolio along with you. It's not mandatory though.
It's not mandatory.
It's the same for undergraduate guys. So your portfolio is not mandatory. However, if you have a piece of or a collection of your artwork or anything that you would like to show us, you're most welcome to carry it along, and we'd love to have a discussion around it.
In fact, Amit, I'd like to update the students that even those who are applying for the design courses, both bachelor's and master's, if they have a portfolio that they would like the faculty to see, they can carry it and carry it with them at the studio simulator stage. Even though we do not have a specific marks allocated to it, but it's always nice to share your work, and that's a way that we as tutors get to understand a student. So anybody who wants to bring it can bring it. If you don't bring it, you don't lose anything, you don't lose any marks, but if you bring it, you'll get a chance to have a conversation with the faculty around it.
So that was the exam pattern, guys. That's for both fashion business management and fashion design or interior design or communication design students. We will start the, you're expected to report in the campus at 8:15 a.m. in the morning on either of the days, as per the date selected by you. As I said, you will get all the schedule in the admit card. You'll be sent a link for which you can download it from the link that's been shared with you. We have sent a request to your parents asking them to accompany you for at least a couple of hours and spend 2 hours at the campus for an open house session. We'd like to spend some time with them and would want them to spend some time with us to know what is IIAD and how is it that the college has become aspirational over the last 5 years. We're the only college in India right now which is not doing a location-wise entrance exam. So if anybody in India is interested to come to IIAD, they actually have to come down to the college in Delhi and come for the entrance. So we're setting the bars high. We want your parents, you, to come to the college and really see what's so different about IIAD. I've spoken to most of you, I think, in the workshops, if you've been in schools and various places in India. But then, you know, so you know, just to advocate the fact as to what we do differently. We're a college which completely believes in coordination of making and doing things, and also getting the thinking inculcated while you study. And we're really looking at that in the entrance exam. And we're trying to find the right fits who are then aligned into the curriculum, which is not so easy. So we're looking for the right fitment and alignment into the curriculum that we have, because it's a global platform that you would be really studying on. Project-based learning is something that's unique of IIAD. We do not have classrooms in the campus. That makes us most unique. So it's a huge makers lab. The whole campus is a makers lab. To really advocate the saying that we cannot put you inside one box and ask you to think outside the box. So it's huge spaces where we give you open learning and environment for you to work. So yeah, again, I would request you to please bring your parents. We've already communicated to them, so they can come and spend some time with us for the first 2 hours of the day.
In fact, Amit, the students, current students at IIAD have put up work because we've just completed the first semester, and as part of their evaluations and assessments, they've put up a lot of work, which if student applicants and their parents come, will get a chance to have a look. And I always tell every aspirant who wants to be part of design learning, whether at IIAD or elsewhere, that please go, come and see the environment of the institute where you are applying. See if that ambience, that environment vibes with you. Look at the student work. No amount of, you know, conversation, no amount of any other detail that we do this, we are better like this, this is what is good about us. None of that matters. If you come and you see the environment and you find it vibing with you, if you find it resonating with you, you look at the student work, if it inspires you to, you know, to be doing something like this, you want to be a part of this, you know, design is like belonging to a tribe. Design designers, design thinkers, design professionals, they're a tribe. If you want, feel like belonging to this tribe, the kind of work that is being done here, then you should pick it, because it's your future at stake. So I would really urge applicants who are coming for the exam to not only take that opportunity to write the exam. There will be enough time in between for you to go around the campus, look at the student work that is there, and check for yourself if this environment is what you are looking for. If this environment inspires you, if it excites you, then join us.
Giving you a few details of the affiliations and the degrees that's awarded, you get a Kingston degree. We have a dual degree program where you get a degree from the Kingston School of Art, which is ranked the number one school of design in the UK this year. We also have a UGC degree from Lingayat Vidyapeeth University, and you get that in bachelor's in the stream that you study, and it's not a dual study that you take up. That curriculum is imbibed, and the university has taken that into consideration. So it's not a dual program, but then the degree is awarded. So you have an Indian validation, and Kingston School of Art, of course, has a validation globally that holds the highest repute in the world. So that's the dual degree. I've often gotten these questions of loans assistance. So yes, we have a facility, and we have 2 to 3 partners we could refer you to for your loan assistance if you do get selected. For every student who is a Medites student, we would offer them a straightforward scholarship, and a link would be sent to you on the email. We also have a means or a need basis scholarship upon acceptance. So all students who wish to apply for it can do so once you are accepted and you're rolled out an offer for admission after the entrance exam. On the day of entrance exam, which is either the 21st or 22nd, we'd be able to tell you when is the result going to be declared. We're still speculating and deciding on that date. So you'd have to bear with us till that day, and we'd be able to tell you on that on the entrance date when the results will be out.
Okay, so I'm going to take a question from Namita Tresia Xavier, who seems to be asking us if there is no interview for bachelors. So Namita, there is an interview for bachelor's program of fashion business management. If you're applying for BA fashion design, communication design, interior architecture design, then there is no interview. But if you're applying for bachelor's in fashion business management, there will be an interview. Then there is a question by Aditya Singh, who's asking us that are we required to bring a portfolio in case of bachelor's for communication design? If you're applying for communication design bachelor's, Aditya, we do not require you to bring, but if you have a portfolio and you would like to share it with us, then you can bring it and share it with your panelists during the studio simulator. That's the interactive activity that will happen in the afternoon. So you are welcome to bring, but it's not mandatory. There is another question. No, I think that's Aditya clarifying this thing. There is a question again by Isha Arora, which says, can bachelor student bring their portfolios? Isha, I hope I have answered your question, that you can, but you are not required to.
Yes. I'll answer this question from Nikita Jain. Nikita, if you do not clear the first round in December with the same application form, you are eligible to sit in the April. It was that last year, but I'll have to check if we do have the same provision for this year. If you do send a communication to us again that you prepared well or something, we will take that into consideration. But then for now, I'll have to get back to you and check. Till last year, we did have that, but this year we'll have to check it again.
Okay, I am taking a question by Dainty Doe. After completing interior architecture and design at IIAD, what are the courses you can do in PG at IIAD? Unfortunately, right now at IIAD, we do not have a postgraduate program that relates to interior architecture and design. However, in Europe and America, there are many programs which would be MA interior, MA space design, MA exhibition design, BA from Kingston, you know, puts you in a good position to apply to any of those master's program. However, at IIAD right now, we do not have a master's program in interior architecture or design. There's a question by Mitali Hemant, which says, when is the whole program expected to get over? Mitali, I'm not very sure about your question. Do you mean when is the whole process of admission expected to get over? I'm responding from that space. So sometime in January, as Amit said, that we are not yet sure when are we going to give out the results, but you can expect it in the earlier part of January itself, when the results would be sent out to you. And then after that, there will be there is no further selection except for those who want to apply for scholarship. And then you'll be given a full schedule of when you can deposit your fees and so on and so forth. But allow us about 3-4 weeks to release the results. We always try to be quick and not keep you waiting. So there is a question from Himanshi Sharma, which says, this time IIAD will give emphasis on DAT or GAT more. Himanshi, I'm not very clear about your question. We have equal weightage for the design aptitude test as well as the studio simulator. In the design aptitude test, there are three sections which I have explained in my presentation. If you look at the sample paper that has been given to you, you will see that the marks distribution, that's about it. We want a well-rounded student. We're not giving importance to one aspect of it. Anukriti Roy asks, how do we prepare for the logical part? Anukriti, that's a great question. Actually, if you ask me, I don't think you should be preparing for any part of the IDAT or for that matter IMAT, because I believe that at IIAD the selection process is such that if you have the aptitude for design and you have the attitude to learn, the system will select you. We don't expect, our exam paper is not set that requires a special kind of preparation or training. But just to support your query, how do you prepare for logical part? There may be a few online supports and books available that teach you logical reasoning, logical thinking. But let me tell you that for the design aptitude test at IIAD, the logical reasoning is more about visual logic. So if I show you a diagram and I tell you that I'm going to fold the paper in this way, what is going to be the result? Now, those are the kind of questions that you will get. It requires you to think visually and logically. Okay. Amit, I think you can take this question by Avleen. She's asking, what are the tentative dates for the April entrance exam?
I cannot give you specifics, Avleen, but we have thought of spreading the first, spreading 5 days, consecutive dates in the second week of April. We're still trying to look at various possibilities of some other, festivities and holidays in April. So it will be 5 dates that you can choose from. It will be more or less in the second week of April for now, but then let us get back to you with the specifics. Yeah.
So Avleen, to add to what Amit said, I think we need to consider, because a lot of applicants at IIAD are also are students who have appeared for their class 12th this year, and therefore we expect that they are applying to various colleges not only in design, but maybe different disciplines. So we want our admission exam dates to not clash with those. So we'll take care of that. And we will also take care that the dates are announced well in advance so that students who are traveling to Delhi from outside have enough time to make bookings. So, but I mean, keep your eyes open and keep looking at the website. And if you've already applied or shown your interest, you will get regular updates from us through emails. There's a question by Mansha Sahani. Mansha asks, what materials to carry for the studio test? Mansha, you don't need to carry anything for specific for the studio simulator. We provide all material. Your basic stationery kit, which you will carry for the written exam, which will include your pencil and eraser and pen and a scale, that should be enough. Everything else will be provided to you, including things like Fevicol and tape. We provide all of that. Mitali Hemant asked, are we required to get our own food? Mitali, I think you are a very you're a good planner. I like this question. So there's a cafeteria on campus, and you can buy your own food. There are some interesting dhabas around you can eat. Nathu's is also close by, which is a sweet shop, and they serve some excellent sweets as well as savory dishes. You can go there and buy, and you can get your own food. If you're hygienic and health conscious, then you can get your own food. We will not stop you. There is enough space for you to sit around and enjoy the food that you've got and maybe share some with us. Okay. Namita, I see, has asked a question that there is no, are there no interviews for bachelor program? I will repeat, I've answered this, but I'm going to repeat it. There is no interview for bachelor's fashion design, communication design, interior architecture design, but there is an interview for bachelor's in fashion business management. There is a repeat question by Suhani, when will the results be announced?
I think we've covered this. We will be able to give you a specific date on the date of entrance exam.
Priyali Kumar asks, do we have the exam first and then the interview? Priyali, I'm assuming that you've applied for one of our postgraduate programs. Yes, the exam, the written exam will be in the morning and then followed by the interview with a short break in between for you to go and grab a bite. In the afternoon, the interviews will be scheduled for the master's program as well as for the fashion business management programs. Okay. Kriti Agarwal has a question. What if all the questions are attempted really well with all details, etc., but one question unattempted or something like that? Do you really lose a chance? Kriti, don't worry so much. Just do your best. Do whatever you can. And as I said, that if you have the aptitude for design, if you have the passion for it, if you have the attitude to learn, I assure you that the system of selection at IIAD will find you. And you will be offered a seat. Don't take so much stress. That's what I'm saying. Not only to Kriti, to everybody. You know, the easiest way to screw up an exam is to get stressed about it. Okay, Pranav Goswami. For the IDAT BA honors in fashion design, leaving the written exam and the studio simulator, can we carry our portfolio? Yes, I've already answered this. You can carry your portfolio, but it is not mandatory. Carry it and bring it and show it rather to your panelists, the tutor who will be there during your studio simulator in the afternoon, right? They will be able to review. No, we will not be in a position to review it in the morning during the written exam. Okay. For BA fashion design after the round one and round two, what is the marks percentage of the two rounds for the final merit? Yes, that is a question by Aparna Sharma, I think. It's an equal weightage. We think that both are important because as Amit was saying, that at IIAD, we really create a bridge between thinking and making. So the first part of it tests both thinking and making because drawing is also making. The second part the making, the three-dimensional making with hands-on work is what is important, whereas there is thinking involved in it. So there's an equal weightage. Okay, I see this question repeating again and again. Aditya Singh, do we need to bring a portfolio? I think I've answered that. Yes, you can bring, but it's not necessary.
But Aditya, if you're asking this third time, please do bring your portfolio. I don't want to see a portfolio.
Yes, we're all excited to see your portfolio. But I can tell you this, not only to Aditya, to everybody else. You bring an excellent portfolio, but you don't perform well in your IDAT written exam or studio simulator. The portfolio is not a replacement for it. Yeah, it can add to it, but you will not get admission on the basis of an excellent portfolio. We want to see you perform in the design aptitude test and the studio simulator, but the portfolio will be a cherry on the cake. We would love to get to know the creative side of you. Okay. Pranav Goswami says that he has not received the mail with the sample paper.
Pranav, if that is your name and that's not an alias that you're using for chats, I will look up your application. You will have a sample paper by tomorrow morning.
And
if I do not find your application with that name, I'd request all of you to please take a note of my phone number. That's 9871-383-630. I'll put that in the chat box also so you can see. Please send me a WhatsApp message with your name, your mobile number and your email address for any other query if you may have, like your admit cards not received or sample paper not received. If you need the assistance into locating our office, whatever it may be, just let me know.
Okay, we have a lot of questions, so I think the session is probably going to extend, Amit. So Himanshi Sharma asks, will both rounds be on the same day? Yeah. Yes, they will be for you. You would be given assigned either 21st or 22nd. Both the rounds will be on the same day for every candidate.
We have 10 minutes left, so we'll go through.
We're going to quickly take some questions. Muskan Gupta says, like you said, we don't have to be perfect in drawing skills and only need to be creative to convey our creativity. What exactly should we do? Think clearly, draw clearly. Don't worry about making photo finished drawings is what I mean. So don't worry about it. And in fact, our questions say that you only a line drawing is sufficient. At that time, don't unnecessarily start shading and coloring the drawing and trying to make it look beautiful. Because if we are asked for a line drawing, you just give us a line drawing. Wherever we are asking you to use color or shade it and things like that, you use it at that time. Is the scholar, so Ruchika Goswami asks, is the scholarship program also for candidates?
So I'd answer this question with historical data, Ruchika. We have seen so we have a limited number of scholarship seats that we can offer. Most of these seats will be offered for students appearing in the December cycle. Whatever remaining will be then given to students in April. So it becomes a little more competitive in the April cycle. In December, it's you have all the scholarship seats for you to avail. Yeah.
First come, first serve. So if you're really keen to get a scholarship, I would suggest that you apply in the December cycle, because if all this, we have limited scholarships. So if all the scholarships are taken, then we may not be able to offer as many at the April cycle time. Adhish asks, the date we have chosen, that's the date for the exam, or would it be changed, Amit?
It's unlikely to be changed, Adhish. Tomorrow is the date when the admit card really goes out. Unless it's a rare exception, please reach out to me. I've given my details. And we'll try and see if I can accommodate it, because we've really numbered you guys and allocated seats in the college and printed your names, etc. So it'll be a logistical challenge for me, but then please reach out to me and talk to me.
Okay. Mansha Sahani, Amit, I think you can take this question. How many seats are available?
So we have 60 seats per stream. So that's we have four streams in the college for undergraduate program. Fashion, interior, communication, that's 60 is 180 seats for the design courses and 60 seats for the fashion business management course.
Okay. Kriti Agarwal again asks a very good question. In what year do we choose our specialization, like for communication, film, video, or animation, etc.? Kriti, I'll elaborate a little bit. So the program is for 4 years. The first year is foundation, which is common to all the three design disciplines, fashion communication, as well as interior architecture design. Then you move to your specialization. Now, within the specialization, you continue to study all the various disciplines within it. Like if you're choosing communication, which I'm assuming from your question, you will study animation, graphics, branding, film, and so on and so forth, UX, UI, through your 2 years. And then in your final year, there is no selection. You don't choose a specialization. What you do is that you start, you do your internship in the field that you want to specialize in. We have a 16-week long internship and an 8-week long internship. So you do, you can choose to do your internships in the specialization. There are also projects that you work on, and within which you have the option of selecting the stream that you would work in. So you make those choices at that time. So essentially, it's in the final year that your specialization really starts taking shape, because we believe that before that, you really need to experience everything and then make an informed choice about what you want to specialize in. How many questions will be there in IIAD? Janvi Tiwari asks. Janvi, I would not know. I would not remember, but I don't think you should be worried about that. Please look up the sample paper, and what you will see is, I think maybe 5-6 questions in the visual ability, and about 15 odd questions, 15 odd questions in the cultural awareness, which are MCQs. Yeah, so please look for that.
So guys, we'll be actually skipping some of the questions which have been repeated. We will not answer them. Like, when would the be out? I'm guessing this is for the results. We have addressed that. Will maths be assessed in IDAT?
No, maths will not be assessed in the design aptitude test. We are not assessing that. There are a lot of questions about portfolio. I've already answered. There's a question about how can we prepare for studio simulation. It's simulation. Basic Sanya Bhaduria has asked. You cannot prepare for it, but what you can do is that you can start getting a hang of material. So start working with your hands, make things with your hand, so that you don't feel very surprised when there is a material in your hand. But there's no way to prepare for it, right? How many seats do you offer for BACD?
60
seats. I'm sorry guys, I'm going a little fast, because is there any MA course for interior architecture? No. Do our parents need to come with us?
Yes.
Yes. They should come with you so that they can also review the college. There will be an open house where the senior management and faculty will be taking questions. It is a great opportunity for them to test us. While we are testing you, your parents can test us. Can you tell me about your collaboration with
I think I've already covered that. You collaborate with Kingston School of Art. You get a degree upon successful completion of the program. We have
I'm going to maths. Scroll. Maths. There's a question about maths. No, we are not checking maths. When will the results be announced? January. Is there a Anushka Taneja asked, is there any specific section we should focus more on? No, Anushka, please look at the sample paper, and for us everything is important. IIAD is not assessing us on sketching skills, but on our composition skills and observations. Won't our sketching skills at all be considered? When I say that we're not looking at your sketching skills, we're not looking at how beautifully can you draw, but are you able to represent your idea visually? That is what we are checking. I know it's difficult to understand that. Please explain the difference between IIAD and IMAT again. IIAD is Design Aptitude Test. It is for the design programs, which is BA Fashion Communication IAD and MA Fashion. IMAT is for the two fashion business management programs. How can I apply for scholarship? Once you are selected, along with your offer letter, you will be sent the application form for scholarship. How are the merits for scholarship decided? It is dependent on your performance in the entrance exam, both the written and the studio simulator. Plus, there will be a form sent to you in which you would be asked to answer a few questions. Based on that, we have a panel that will score your application, and the top scorers will be offered the scholarship.
So it'll be like this, guys. If you are meritorious in your results, we would upfront offer you as a merit student a merit basis scholarship. If need be and you do not clear a merit basis scholarship, you'd request for it, and we evaluate your income and etc., and on the basis of means we would offer that scholarship to you. So it's all funds. There's a question somebody asked that they missed about the degree that I spoke of. So there's a dual degree that we offer. You get on successful completion of the course. One is from Kingston School of Art. It's a degree by this UK university. It's ranked number one in UK this year. We have got the curriculum from Kingston School of Art has been accepted and imbibed with Lingayat Vidyapeeth University in India. So you do not study extra to get the dual degree in bachelor's into the stream that you do, like for bachelor's for fashion design, you get a bachelor's in fashion, and so on. For communication and interiors, you get a UGC degree from Lingayat Vidyapeeth University.
There's another question by Tanvi which says that do we get a diploma or a degree? Tanvi and everybody else, you get a degree, and a BA honors degree or a MA degree. There is no diploma that we give. The diploma, I don't know where there is, that is. There's no diploma. There is only a degree.
We do not consider UCED examination score, guys.
Yeah. So Abhya has asked that. Do you consider UCED examination score? No, we do not. There is a question. Do we have a foundation course in the first year? Yes, we do, and that's mandatory.
I saw a question. If you do get a chance to go to Kingston. We are hopeful that something like that happens in the coming few months. We cannot be sure, but then Kingston University has really shown great interest in Indian students, and now you have come up the learning curve. So yes, that is most likely in the coming time.
And not just that, we're going to put into place lots and lots of other exchange opportunities with other foreign universities. We are in the last 2 minutes, and I'm going to hope to take some important questions. There are lots. I'm sorry that we're not able to address all. There's a question: is there any percentage required in 12th for entering IIAD?
50%.
It's 50%. You should have scored a minimum of 50% aggregate in your class 12th. For masters in fashion management, what all topics need to be covered in the exam? It's the same for what I said for IMAT: logical reasoning, English language, and basic awareness about fashion. What if our parents are not able to come? Joshia asks. Joshia, that's all right. It's not mandatory. It's okay if they cannot come, but we would love to have your parents here so that they can look at the campus and check the place on their own and satisfy themselves.
So I'll just cover the last question, which says, what are the placement opportunities at IIAD? Guys, the whole curriculum of IIAD is project-based learning. We get projects. It's not a hypothetical project that you're working on. So over the period of 4 years that you're working at IIAD, you'd be working at several projects that come from the industry, and you're exposed to a certain atmosphere that exists in the environment of industry around you. So you fairly know how the opportunities are outside, and they fairly know you as an individual. So you already have a certain amount of work experience before you step into the real world. So placements are not a problem at IIAD at all.
The last two questions probably I'll get. One is that by what time will we get free from the interviews? It's very difficult to say because there'll be a list of students. Safely to say about 4 or 5 in the evening. There is a question again about what are the number of.
So if you're a Delhi student, you can probably go home at 3:30. If you're an outstation student, we'll take you to see the accommodation. If you're a Delhi student and you want to stay away from your parents, you can come with us to see the accommodation and leave by 5:30.
Yeah.
And I will just. I'm sorry. I cannot take more questions. There are like 60 more questions here. I will drop in my phone number here in the answer box. That's 9871383630. My name is Amit. please send me a WhatsApp message of any questions, query listed here or not listed here, anything that you may have, you will have an answer to it.
So I hope this session was helpful to all of you. We hope to see you at IIAD campus. Any questions that you have, please write to Amit, his email ID, or whoever you have been in touch with. They will be happy to answer all your questions. Sorry that we could not address all of them. We ran short of time. And thank you. Have a nice evening.